4 years. That may not seem like a long time at first, but you really can stop and think about it and go, wow, 4 years is a long time. 4 years is the exact number of years I have been in high school. It also happens to be the same amount of years I've been doing the PHS News. Yes, that's right. I didn't just waltz in the studio this year, claim ownership, and just nail it on camera first try. No, no. I've been doing this for 4 years, and as it turns out, when I was a freshman, I was really nervous on camera. I didn't even want to be in front of a camera. I didn't want to record my voice. I was a lot shyer then. But here we are, 4 years later, and this is just as normal as talking to any other person. Today's episode of the PHS News is pretty special. It's also a little somber for me. This is what will officially be my final episode ever. After this, I say goodbye. I don't do any of this, really, officially, anymore. Now, this may or may not be the last episode of the 2019-2020 school year. There's still talks about what's going on next. I think that there will be one more episode past this, but I don't think it will be me sitting in this chair or even in this room. To some, the PHS News may seem like just this silly little program we put on week after week. But to us, and especially me, this is something that we put so much effort, so much energy, we pay so close attention to it, and we try really hard every single week to bring you all something, whether it be actual news or during these past couple weeks of quarantine, a fun little distraction from online schoolwork and actually boring and kind of tragic news. The past 4 years have been full of friendships, laughter, hardships, stress, but overall just really good memories. And so for my last news episode, I'd like to get a little nostalgic, and I'm going to play the PHS News intro that I had when I joined in my freshman year. So, for one last good time, let's do this. Good morning, afternoon, and or evening, Pooter students, staff, and other community members. My name is Tom, and welcome back to another episode of the PHS News. First up, before we get started, let's talk to some more student athletes.
I'm Tanis. I'm a jumper in track. I'm going to be going to college next year. I'd like to thank my parents and my coaches for the support, and my favorite memory is running patterns in the snow on the track with my teammates.
I'm Riley. I play track and field, and my main events in track are high jump and hurdles. My favorite memory from track, I would just have to say in general, is like every meet we go to. I love the atmosphere of everyone cheering for each other, or, you know, the feeling that you get when your team's coming around the final curve for the 400 and everyone's rattling the fences, or the feeling right when I clear height and high jump. So I'd say like meets in general. And then I guess also the bus rides down are really fun. I would like to thank my parents for their support throughout all the years, my sister, and also a huge thank you to my teammates and coaches because they are really what drives me and motivates me to, you know, be better. I want to be better for the team and myself. And I think having that team camaraderie really helped build everyone up. So I wanted to thank my teammates for that. And finally, my plans next year are kind of open. I want to study biology and environmental studies. And I most likely will be competing in track in college. I have not committed anywhere yet, but I have a lot of great options.
Hi, I'm John, and I run on the track team. My favorite memory for running on the track team was my junior year. And I was on the 4x8 team, and it was the conference meet. I got the baton in third place, and I was the anchor leg. And I was about 100 meters behind the first place guy, and at the end, I ended up catching up to him and beat him at the last 100 meters. I'd like to thank God for giving me the ability to run and giving me the strength and courage throughout the years. I would also like to thank my parents and my family members for coming out and supporting me. I'd like to thank my teammates for pushing me during practice and my coaches for making me a stronger athlete. My plans for next year is to run at Western on their track and cross country team.
I'm Ryan. I competed in track and cross country. I'd like to thank all my coaches over the years. Favorite memory of my track experience is a pretty cool memory.
My name is Mark. I run track and field. My favorite memory from track is winning conference my junior year in the 4x8. I'd like to thank my coaches, my teammates, and my family for all their support throughout my track career. And next year, I'm planning on going to Colorado Mesa University to study mechanical engineering.
Hi, my name is Hannah. I was going to do track this year. Obviously, wasn't able to because of the circumstances. But here's this video of some things that I'd like to say. So one of my favorite memories over the years was when I made it to state last year. That was my goal ever since I started pole vaulting my freshman year. And it just meant a lot to me to make it and to get to compete down there. I made my PR of 9'3" at the time. And afterwards competing there, one of my coaches, who was a long jump coach at the time, she bought me my state patch. And she is one of the first people that I'd like to thank. Her name is Autumn. She coached for 2 years as a long jump coach, and I only had her for one of those. But I'd like to thank her. First of all, she's an EMT, so she's helping out in this situation right now and working really hard, as well as she was always there to make me smile at practice. And she cheered for me the loudest, which, I don't know, it meant a lot. So thank you, Autumn, so much.
My name is Kaylee. I participate in track and field. The best memory I have was during my sophomore year. I went to a track dinner, and I had just had a blast with a whole bunch of my track friends. I'd like to thank Coach Thomas. He's helped me improve so much throughout the last few years. And after high school, I am going to the University of Colorado, Colorado Springs, to get a major in political science.
Hi, my name is Tommy. I ran track. My favorite memory is probably running on the 4x4. And I'd like to thank all the coaches for helping me get better. And I plan on going to Front Range Community College next year.
Awesome. Now, we had a contest, the very last contest. Last episode, I showed you my awesome quarantine resort. And unfortunately, Mother Nature has not permitted me to go outside and film it for real or do anything in my pool. And so it's just been sitting there, still in my basement, not full of water, and I don't get to use it. It is literally dumping rain. And the past couple days have been very chilly and windy. And frankly, I don't want to get in cold hose water and then get sick at a time like this. But my challenge was for all of you to create your own quarantine resort. And we had a whopping one submission. Congratulations to John Berlingmeyer for this awesome quarantine resort. It looks fantastic and very cozy. Now, we have another game night tonight at 8 on Kahoot. If you follow Pooter_Impalas on Instagram, you'll get the game code there, as well as our Twitter, @ImpalaTweets. It's going to be Finish the Movie Quote. And lastly, as it is my final episode, I'd like to just give a little bit of an Oscar acceptance speech. So if you'll just stay tuned for just one more second, I have a few people I'd like to thank. First off, I'd like to thank Wout Bocart for setting the record for 7 semesters straight of TV so that I could break it with now 8 semesters straight of TV. That's right. I did the impossible. Was it all pleasure? No. Was a lot of it stressful? Kinda. Was it worth it? Definitely. I'd like to thank every single member of the PHS News crew, past or present. Working with everyone has been such a pleasure over the years. I'd like to thank the old TV teacher, Ms. Colburn, who was here for 3 years of my 4-year experience. It's been so amazing, and she was the one who really motivated me to get out of my shell and be on camera and be a bigger presence. I'd like to thank Ms. Mosnick for stepping up this year after Ms. Colburn left and being such an amazing creative spirit in the studio. Your ideas have really elevated this show, and I cannot thank you enough. And lastly, of course, I would like to thank all of you for tuning in week after week. I'd especially like to thank the teachers who watch the PHS News every week, even though it technically wasn't required. Everyone who's watched this, every student, every staff member who's tuned in every single week to watch the news, it has made such an incredible difference. And I can't really imagine a high school life without the PHS News. It's been a real pleasure, and it's really sad for me to let this go, but I'm afraid I have to move on. Rest assured, the PHS News is moving into better hands than perhaps my own. I definitely think I did a good job, but I have no doubt that the PHS News crew that's moving in next year is going to do an even better job. So now, for one final time, I'd just like to say this. Thank you, Poudre High School, for tuning in again with me this week and for the last 4 years. It's been something I'll never forget. And this has been Tom with your PHS News. Goodbye.